We have completed the prophase 1 where we got what? We got a 46 different chromosomes, or all are in a pair, right? Or 23 pairs we have, and all the 23 pairs we have are different chromosomes in it. So what happened after the prophase? We'll see a metaphase, anaphase and telophase. So the first thing, just keep in mind, what exactly happens after the prophase? As you all know that which type of chromosomes are there in a prophase? Assume this is a one chromosomes, and this is a one cell. We have what? We have a four different chromosomes are there, and in our four different chromosomes, we have a information with it, right? Not here. This part. And a blue one is here. Okay, and with having what? With having a different chromosomes. Okay, so all are four new one. All are new one are there. So in a metaphase, what happened in a metaphase? Metaphase, what happens? So in a metaphase, this suppose that this is a one cell where first thing in a metaphase, all the chromosomes comes at middle of this cell, middle of this cell, or a cytoplasm. This is also called as or metaphasic plate, or on metaphasic plate. Okay, all are comes under what? A metaphasic plate. So this is a what? A metaphasic plate in a center, and in a center all the chromosomes are what? So homologous chromosomes are comes, so let's keep in mind. So here is one chromosomes. So all the chromosomes what? Homologous chromosomes are comes together, and here they have, you know, they do not have what? A nuclear membrane, and they have what? They are opposite, you can say, a chromosome centrosomes are moving towards the opposite pole. So just think that centrosomes are reached over there. Okay, nuclear membrane are not there. So two chromosomes are what? Are arranged here in a on metaphasic plate. And this one, and we all also know that a centromere have what? A chromatin, one of the protein. So in a metaphase, spindle fibers which are formed are attached towards centrosomes. It attached to the centrosomes. So we can write that a spindle fibers are attached. Spindle fiber attached to kinetochore. What is kinetochore? It's a protein. It's adjacent to the centromere. It's called as what? Kinetochore. So kinetochore and the spindle fibers are attached. Or you can say this form what? It's happening in a metaphase. Now, in a second one, or you can say a third, it's anaphase. In a anaphase, what happening? Okay, so in here we can write a anaphase, what happening? A anaphase, what happening in a anaphase? Okay, so in a anaphase, or ana means what? A stands for away. Away is going on, means two homologous chromosomes are going away from each other, means homologous chromosomes are going away from each other. Okay, which is called as what? A anaphase, which is happening in a anaphase. So if you see a diagram over there, so assume that this is a cell which does not have a nuclear membrane, which does not have any organelles. This homologous chromosomes are separating. In a mitosis, if you remember, our sister chromatids are separated, but in this part homologous chromosomes are separated, right? This is happening in metaphase 1 or anaphase 1. This is a meiosis 1, where the homologous chromosomes are separated one. So in a anaphase, homologous chromosomes are separated, centrosomes are here. So this one are called as what? A black one. This is a blue over there. This is what? A centrosomes which having attached over there. And here is a black one. Which is attached over there. So this is here your two separated, you can say, homologous chromosomes are there. Now in a last phase, what happening, which is called as its a last steps, which is called as a telophase 1. Telophase 1. So what happening in telophase 1? As we all know that in a telophase, all the prophase ka opposite, right? Means NM. NM is what? Nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane reappear. Okay, nuclear membrane reappear. All the organelles reappear. All organs reappear. Okay, and along with that, nucleolus also comes together. So in a telophase, just keep in mind, this is a cell. This is a cell where spindle fibers, dissolve and disappear. We can say disappear or dissolve. So these spindle fibers are not there. Centrosomes are there. Centrosomes are present along with what? Along with that chromosomes. Along with chromosomes, spindle fibers are not there. Okay. So there are the two chromosomes is there, but they do not have what? They do not have a spindle fibers. Along with that, they have what? They form a nucleolus. So along with the nucleolus, they start forming what? A nucleus, they start forming in it. Okay, so the nuclear membrane reappear in both these phase. So we have a two nucleus, right? We have a two nucleus, and here also the cytoplasm, they have what? A different, we can say that a part is there. In a telophase, we know that in a animal cell it's not given, but in a plant cell, in a plant cell, or you can say cell plate develop. Cell plate are formed for help in cytokinesis. Help in what? Cytokinesis. So what the last step? What the last step of this meiosis one, which is called as what? Cytokinesis. As you all know that in a cytokinesis, what happened? This cell is divides. So there is a one cell and there is a one cell which is for a cleavage furrow, which forms what? A cleavage furrow, and they divide from outside in a animal cell and from inside with the help of cell plate from, you can say, in a plant cell, with having what? We're having what? 23 number of chromosomes with nucleus. Here also 23 number of chromosomes, because you will see they have 46 number of chromosomes here, but here 23, here 23. So in a cytokinesis after, they form a haploid cell, which is called as what? You can say daughter cell. So this thing happening here in a, you can say meiosis one. Okay, so here we have completed a meiosis one. In next video, we'll see that a meiosis two, which is similar to the mitosis, how, or you can say, or you can say everything in a meiosis two carried out, how these two cells are basically formed of four daughter cells with the same number of chromosomes. So in the next video, we'll see everything. Hope you have understood a meiosis one of after prophase one processes. So these are basically are the process of what, or you can say a meiosis one. Yeah, thank you so much.